Hello pals, and welcome back to another vlog. This is going to be my travel vlog for this year because tomorrow I am going back to the UK, but I thought I would start this vlog today with my last minute packing. You should be able to see my desk right now because that is hella messy because I just have lots of things on it that need to be packed. I also have a lot of packing lists on my phone at the moment, both things that need to be done today and things that need to be done tomorrow morning. I'm leaving tomorrow at like 9:15 to go to the airport, so I have quite a lot of time tomorrow morning as well to just like pack and stuff considering how early I get up. But now I thought I would do a little bit of packing and show you what goes on. So my suitcases are now packed. The literal only thing I have left to pack is this, my little tumbler like mug thing, and then my little beauty pouch. But obviously I have my toiletries and stuff in there, so that can't come until tomorrow morning. I just realised that I have to get my suitcase open again and find an adapter, which I have to move into my carry-on, so that is quite annoying, but that is the only thing I have to get my suitcase open for. But now I thought I would let you come with me and trial pack my carry-on bag. Obviously these are things that will kind of get in and out as we go, but let's pack it from the start, shall we? Let's tidy it first of all. So, things that have to go in this bag. Chargers, lots of chargers. I have one charger hanging out here on my desk. Charging my iPad at the moment. Let's see if that's full. That is full. And I'm gonna get that charger out and put it in the bag. It's one of these really, really long ones that are absolutely amazing to have, but also a pain in the bum if you don't have anything to pack them in. So, I might get like a hair tie, something, put around this. Do I have one? No. Probably not. Oh well. So in here, what's going in here? My iPad is going in here. Do I have a pouch to put that in? Probably not. Okay, iPad, and then my planner is obviously coming in the carry-on because we all know that I can't live without this thing for more than approximately 7 minutes. So that is coming with us. When I pack my bags, I always like to start with like the flat things against one of the sides. Then I'm bringing cake because obviously, what else would you bring on a flight with you? That's quite essential. Then I have this little pouch of literally all the things in my life. It has a bajillion random things in it and I don't wanna even start to guess what's in there because I have no idea. I should probably clean that out. Then Tangled headphones, which is obviously an essential for any flight, although I prefer mine not to be tangled, so I'm gonna wrap them up. I just like roll them around my hand like that. I really want to get one of those like little taco things to bundle them in, but for now just using a hair grip. I'm gonna put that in the pouch as well. Pop that on the side, and then because I travel quite a bit, I just have all my liquids perpetually in a little liquids bag. So that's all set. Then I have a tote bag because you never know when you need an additional bag. And I forgot to mention I have another charger that is also going in here because that's where that lives. when we're out and about. Then I have this random comb. I'm just gonna pop that in there as well. And then we have my wallet, which also has my passport in it, which is handy to have when you're going abroad, because you don't want to risk not getting there. Then we have this charger. And I am quickly running out of room, which is not fab. This is gonna be hella heavy. It always is. Then I was also planning on bringing this, which is my knitting, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to fit it all in there, but technically I'm gonna take some of it out. Sorry, that was probably very noisy. If you watched my last vlog, I told you about the knitting. Knitting a cardigan, and this bit of the cardigan is already done, so I can pop that in my other suitcase. So I only have to bring this. Does it close? Yes, for now. Will it close tomorrow? It might. Let's see if I have anything that I'm packing tomorrow that I have forgotten to put in there. Adapters, one adapter. Okay, that's it. Just another adapter. It's going in here. Won't have room for any food other than the cake, as you do. But yeah, so that's gonna be all the packing for now. For now, I'm gonna unpack this again and then see if I can actually fit it tomorrow. We'll see, I'll let you know. So it's the next morning. I'm guessing it's about 7:30 or like 7:40, and I've just finished packing. I just have a couple of bits that need to go in my carry-on bag. My cake, my wallet, my little pouch, and my phone, which is currently charging, and the charger that it's charging on. And that is literally it. I've done my makeup, I'm dressed, I'm just putting on some lipstick and then having some food, and that's it. So my mum woke me up about 7:45 to have breakfast with her before she left. She did a lot of crying. I, as usual, did not cry. And yeah, everything is as normal in this household on travel day. So I've just finished packing my suitcases. They are heavy AF. Taxi for me up to the flat, I think, because I don't think I can get up in any other way. But yeah, I am very, very ready to go. I'm very ready to see Helge. It's so weird because we only live like a 30-minute drive away from each other, but I've literally seen her twice over the summer. She's been working a lot and it is a hassle to go see each other, so we've been texting lots, but it's not the same as seeing her almost every day. And now I'm gonna go back to seeing her every day. It's gonna be great. So we are traveling together today. We're not sitting together on the plane, but we are gonna hang out at the airport during our layovers and stuff, which is gonna be fab. I love having someone to travel with, just because it makes it so much less boring, just because I am so done with these long ass travel days. I think I'm going to wrap this up so that I can pack my camera, because that's the only thing I have left to pack. And then I'm gonna have breakfast, I'm gonna have a cup of coffee, and then just wait for us to leave. So I think I'm gonna try to get some clips, but I'm also just gonna put in all my Instagram stories from the day. I hope you enjoy a little look at how my travel day went, and I'll definitely update you when I get back to the UK. And then I figured I should show you my outfit for the day. So this is it. And I'm also gonna wear my loafers that I usually wear. So this blazer is from H&M, and I like it for travel just because it's a bit less hassle than a trench coat, and it still does the work as a jacket, so that's good. And it's also not that great to pack, so I like traveling in it. Then I have this t-shirt from H&M from ages ago, then these trousers are from Topshop, and then this belt is from somewhere, I don't know. I am gonna be wearing shoes. Woohoo!
really needs to shower. I just casually dropped off the face of the earth for a little bit there. It is now the next day and it's 1 p.m. So just a little recap of yesterday. Everything went pretty smooth, which was really nice. Me and Hek had a lovely time just hanging out at the airport. But then our second flight was about 35 minutes delayed both ways. It was really annoying, but it was all right, obviously. And I had quite a long wait for my bus anyway, so just cut some time in between that. So that was all right, really. But then when I got on my bus, it goes from kind of the central bus station at Heathrow to Terminal 4, then to Terminal 5, and then it leaves. And between central bus station and Terminal 4, it's supposed to take 15 minutes, but instead it took 55. And that's kind of the degree of delay we stayed at. So I got here quite a bit later than expected. And Hay and her boyfriend were lovely enough to come pick me up, save me the money for a taxi. So they came pick me up, and then they were dinner, and I just had some pasta and some stuff I had in the flat already, because I really couldn't be asked with any more effort than that. And I ended up not going to bed until about midnight because I was unpacking frantically and trying to sort things out. And I actually fully unpacked yesterday, and then today I have spent a lot of time just organising and decluttering and stuff like that. I didn't film any of it because I didn't want to bother with kind of having to set up the camera and stuff when I was already a bit like all over the place, and that was not the first thing I wanted to have to figure out in my new room. So that did not happen. But rest assured, I have done lots of things. And I think I'm pretty much done at the moment. I have a couple of more boxes that I need to get from IKEA. And then I have some kitchen stuff I need to get from IKEA as well. But I think I've pretty much sorted out my storage. I'll see when I start taking my kind of winter clothes out of my vacuum bags what I end up doing then, because I have no clue what I'm gonna do about that, but for now it's all right. And then today I went into town. I had to get some like hangers and like cotton pads and whatever random things. I was gonna book a hair appointment. The lady I was gonna book it with is on maternity leave. Gonna book a nail appointment. Turns out they don't do acrylic hair anymore, and I was just like, please. I had a long day yesterday. But before I went to town, I also stopped by campus for a bit, just doing some work, having some breakfast because there was no food in the flat, and bumped into a friend there, so we had a good catch up, which was nice. And now, as I said, it's 1 p.m. I'm pretty much finished with most of the things I need to do today. I need to change the head of my toothbrush. It's another thing I need to do today, and I need to do a food shop, get one ordered so that I have some food. Probably gonna order dinner tonight just because cooking is not a thing when you don't have any food. So need to do a food shop, have that delivered hopefully tomorrow or maybe on Sunday. And yeah, also need to figure out when I'm going to IKEA. I think that's all I have to update you on for now. There is going to be a room tour obviously at some point, but we will have to see when I feel like the space is ready for that, if you know what I mean. Still a couple of things I need to figure out, and as I said, still a couple of things I need to get. But I think with this wrap up, this intensely long wrap up, I think that is going to be the end of this vlog, because I don't want to drag it on. I hope you have enjoyed this video, no matter how kind of scattered it was, and I will see you in my next one. Until then, take care.
That you need more space. What are you, an astronaut?